Oh, is that Herod? Thanks for all the goodies, Herod. I just want to read the note, and the maggots just keep coming. They don't stop coming, and they don't stop coming, and they don't stop coming, and they don't stop coming. Get out of here. Oh my good god. Stop it.
That skill's not ready.
I just want to immerse myself in the deep lore. I had to pause in my exploration. I've lost track of time, and the air here is thin. I found the driest place I could lay down. I know not how long I slept, but I was awoken by large grubs spraying something viscous all over my clothes, almost like spider webs. Now my skin tingles where it was exposed. I dread to think what would have happened if I had not awoken when I did. Would I have been devoured in my sleep, my senses dulled by the strange sludge? The horrid things retreated when I brandish my sword, but I know they are not far behind as I walk. They are in no rush to have their inevitable meal. I thought my loyalty to Tuho would be how I forged my name in the ranks of the Temple Guard. I must have angered the priests somehow. But what could I have done? I can think of no altercation that would have them do this to me. Unless this fate awaits all who know the location of the seals? How do two people keep a secret? One kills the other. The lore is deep.
Can't do that yet.
As deep as the Maw of Ennahot. Yeah. Deep lore, etc., etc. This game, like, generally speaking, I'm not big on text lore entry in games. I kind of give it to this because it's like, kind of a AA title, so it's how they're going to do a lot of their stellar storytelling. But at the same time, it's just all so grimdark that I'm like, alright, this is a fun read. Lore never changes. I think lore never changes is the better of the two.
That skill's not ready.
Worms? Nope. Yeah, that tends to be the problem with like lore-based journal entries in games is that they way overdo it. It's like, oh yes, welcome to Call of Duty Warmaster 2020. We have 3,000 pages worth of lore about, I don't know, ISIS and the Taliban. It's very, very intriguing and not at all copied directly off of Wikipedia. And that now passes for storytelling. Not that I expect them to tell, like, show everything, but it's like, come on now, a little bit here and there. Oh my god, yes. Basically, like, all of Obsidian's games have that problem where they're like, their writers got so into it, they're like sniffing their own farts. It's like, the lore is so good, so we're just going to completely inundate the game with it, and nobody cares that much. Yeah, I agree. Risen was really good about that. Like, there was some lore in that if you poked around and, like, you could find interesting things. But for the most part, it was, like, pretty self-explanatory about how, like, the factions and stuff work. Or they'll be like, yeah, the mages are, like, brainwashing people, and then you see the mages running around with, like, a bunch of brainwashed acolytes and shit. You do... I'm sure there is the one person out there that's got, like, Grim Dawn fanfic. I'm sure. There's probably Grim Dawn fanfic out there. That's fine. It's just... you don't need that much. Like, I get world building, and I think world building is cool, and it's something that I enjoy doing, but at the same time, like, you don't need 50 pages worth of info on, like, a deity. Give me, like, a strong paragraph, and I'm good. Poison damage, what's that? We're just gonna switch to a crossbow build. Completely, and we'll just use, we'll keep using our current attacks. I don't even think we can do some of these attacks if we had a crossbow. Yeah, I'm pretty sure. Take our charge. Oh my god, these worms! Fuck off, you guys!
That skill's not ready.
Yeah, the Dark Souls games is, that's to me how I prefer it as well. Like, there's lore for people that wanna, you know, muck about things, and like it leaves room for like fan theories and stuff. I know some people like a more set in stone method of delivery, but I like being able to kind of piece things together on your own. Fancy pants. Ooh. Yeah, resistance is on them. But our elemental resistances are so overcap, it's not funny, so I'm not gonna worry about it right now.
That skill's not ready.
And I think that's where we came from. Okay, Jesus, this thing just keeps going. It's like it's the size of the desert or something. I'm honestly, like, it would be funny if they had a roguelike dungeon in this place. Maximum troll potential. Cut through all the bugs and shit, and hey, guess what? You can't actually finish the dungeon unless you bring a key with you. And trudge through the bullshit. Not gonna pivot somewhere else. Did they add a new roguelike dungeon with Forgotten Gods? I thought Port Valberry was the last one that they were gonna add. Oh shit. Gerblix the Digested. Alright.
That skill's not ready.
They did? Nice. We'll have to do that. God. And you summon worms, because of course you do, you pustule-filled son of a bitch. Yeah, we'll definitely do the roguelike dungeon for this.
That skill's not ready.
Look at all the green, it's so festive.
Skill's not ready.
I don't know if you guys knew this, but that skill's not ready.
That skill's not ready.
Oh, I hate everything. The first seal of Morganath. What is that? It's got lore on it. In the darkness bound, Morganath's vile tongue saw seven fall from grace. Joined in the night, his fate became theirs. No longer will they bask in the light of the eldritch sun. They crave the cold embrace of night, and so forever will they roam its dark tapestry. The way is shut, the heresy sealed, but should the Corvin faith be shaken once more by Morganath's folly, they seek the second seal where stone meets the bleached sands, beyond the watchful eye of twin griffins. I pray that knowledge of this black stain upon the Corvin lands will be lost with our final breaths. Well, I know what area that's referencing to, because I distinctly recall walking between a pair of big damn griffin statues. Co-op friend with poison build, that one's not mine, oh lord. Oh, is this our bro? Did he feed himself to the Sarlacc? My skin itches and burns, but I must not touch it. Those grubs did something to me and made my flesh soft like meat that had been boiled too long. Ugh. My clothes and armor have started to rot and rust away, and my hair is falling out. I think this living horror I am inside is slowly digesting me. I must hurry and find an exit before my life is spent, and when I do, I'm going to slit that traitor to his throat like the dog he is. I know where they are taking the second seal, and I'll eagerly await their arrival in the shadows of that forsaken fortress. But I only have a little flame left, and I see it flickering, drawn by the subtle breeze. To find one's way out of a cave, one must follow the direction the torch is blowing. By the light of Ron, I will have my revenge. Maybe we'll find this dude yet. Just finished Risen, should you play Risen 2 or Expedition Viking? I've not played Expedition Viking. Risen 2 isn't too bad. I think the first Risen game is better. But Risen 2 isn't too bad. Risen 3 is pretty different. But Risen 2 is enough of the same that if you like the first game, you're probably gonna like the second one too. I thought it was perfectly playable. Oh my god, fuck you worms, I'm not even gonna bother fighting you. Get screwed. I'm out of coffee and I'm butthurt about it too. I drink water like a peasant. Okay, we need to be careful because that hate fucker scorpion's down there. Now, where were those griffins at? Maybe been like here? Okay, here's the two griffins. What did it say? Stone and bleached sand beyond the watchful eye. So, stone, bleached sand. Like, it's gotta be like around here somewhere then, maybe? It doesn't help that it's night and I can't see shit. Really missing that light that I had on that one ring or whatever. Because I know that they can do stuff like where if you approach something, that gates will come down, so it might be just something like hidden out here as opposed to something I necessarily have to click. Brave the ledge. Oh, is that over here? The only problem is that, like, I can't go too far north because that fucking 80th level thing is up there. I think I see it on the map. I think it's right here. Can I rotate the camera? Can we cheese view? No. Before the griffins, not after the griffins. Thank you, Questy. Oh shit. Hey, it's mummies. It's not poison damage. I'll take it. The art design in this game so much. It just looks so good. So good. Yeah, vitality and poison damage. Vitality damage, you say? Oh. Well, that's irksome. At least they don't leave pools of bullshit everywhere for me to stand in. Possessed armor, sure. God, they're summoning bees!
That skill's not ready.
Strip some gear, give them a fighting chance. Hold on. We gotta sell shit.
I'll give you a good price on what I've got left. See you around.
Okay. No. Oh, I love that. I fucking love that they prompt you before you auto sort. They're like, do you want to do this cursed action? Are you sure? And then I can be like, no. I don't want to do that cursed action. Who would ever want to do that cursed action? I'm keeping my metal because I want my ability to jump, and you can't take that away from me. I also want my shield because we kind of need that. Alright. Why am I still using a yellow ring? Oh, it's got resistances on it, but Jesus Christ, Gene. Oh man, on death effects, what are we, Path of Exile? That shit drives me nuts. Enemies shouldn't be dangerous when they're dead. And yet. By God, they're actually dealing damage to me. Oh, I need to... Where is it? Can you disable... Can you disable auto-equipping gear? Don't remember. Because I don't want to be like accidentally equipping shit that I pick up. Exactly. Like, that's one of the things that like bugs the shit out of me with Path of Exile is like, it seems like each new league mechanic they add, it's like more enemies that are dangerous, like more dangerous when they're dead than when they're alive. Shit drives me up the fucking walls. And it's like, I get why they do it. It's because like players one-shot everything, so you've got to give like the enemy some way to be dangerous, but it's like, Jesus. The cannon settings. That's what I thought. I just don't know where it is. Too much about it. No worries. It seems like it's something that would be an option. I actually thought it was in your inventory, but apparently not. Seriously, dude, you're just gonna heal yourself like that? Just gonna go into an action RPG and heal yourself when you're almost dead? Equip that. Equip it. I don't think we can equip it anyways. That's a caster offhand. They did put in the loot filter, yeah, but I want to still pick stuff up. I just don't want to equip it. But yeah, I thought that there was like an option in your inventory you could toggle, but apparently not. Oh, it was a different guy's journal. I was hopeful. Why is the auto equip in the loot filter? Not looking like it. Journal of Captain something or other here. It's okay, I'll just keep an eye on my inventory and make sure that if I equip anything, I take it off. Not that big a deal. I've arrived at my new post and completed my inspection of the fort and its troops. It's a small structure, but impressive in its armaments and the regiment's dedication to their assignment. I was told the fort has no formal name and I was not to issue it one. It is not a matter I intend to question, as my orders were handed down from Vizier Araman himself. The regiment, known as the Blades of Atef, is a formidable one. I have watched them spar, and their skills in combat are frightening, but this comes as no surprise. They've all been trained from a young age as both assassins and soldiers. I have no doubt they will make for excellent guardians should we face any threats. The fort's most notable feature is the long double bridge built over water that flows in from the ocean. Beyond it lies the vault I am to guard with my life. As to what it contains, I was not given specifics, only that the object in question has not yet arrived. I'm not going to jeopardize my fortunes by asking too many questions. This is an excellent post. It is quiet and the salt air is pleasant, much better for my lungs than the damp air of the Cliffs of Abid. I do not think I could have asked for a better assignment. It might be Grim Internals, yeah. Oh, hey. Oh, okay. I thought like that entire wall just animated to attack me, but it just like faded out as the statue spawned. For some reason, sure. My god, these things are gonna just take forever to kill. We just, this is so bad. I mean, I guess to the game's credit, it's forcing me to use healing potions. So note to self, avoid statues. Yeah, no, I'm pretty sure I'm at, like, your base 5% crit chance. 0.5%. 0.5% chance to crit. I don't mean to brag, but I'm kind of a big deal. Hey, turtle shell leveled. Nice. Evil statue. There's down. Okay. Fuck you guys, I'm not fighting you. Jesus. Nope, 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 nope. I've actually got a juke. What is this? This is an action RPG. I'm being forced to employ skill of play and maneuver myself around enemies as opposed to just deleting screenfuls of things at the time. This is not what I signed on for. I'm not here to think. Imported resolute technique. I got resolute technique, but none of the damage. Oh, they're fucking... Are they sapping my mana? I think they are. You fuckers. I need that to kill you, because my basic attacks do nothing. Stop it. Even my non-basic attacks aren't exactly doing much. I think the next waypoint I hit, I'm gonna quit out and flip it onto veteran. Cause like, we're memeing here. I have like no gear. And the only difference, oh goddamn, the only difference is that the fights are just taking longer.
I can't do that yet.
These friggin' things. Ridiculously chonky. And imagine you never played on normal. I only started playing on normal when they like hyper buff the difficulty on veteran, because like the early game is a slog anytime you bump into any of the uniques, because they just have so much health, and like when you're first starting out you don't deal enough damage and it just takes forever to kill things. But yeah, I generally flip over to veteran once you've got a couple levels under you and can actually, you know, kill things. Yeah, see, we're equipping stuff. Knock that off, buddy. None of that. Because yeah, normal is kind of boring. It's good, I mean, I guess it's good for people that want to just like get through the game. There's nothing wrong with that. But at the same time, like, holy damn.
I can't do that yet.
Yeah. I mean, I can see starting on like veteran if you're like passing down gear and stuff. I think that would be a lot more reasonable. Like, just starting on fresh, it's just... It's purely, like, the unique monsters, because, like, your general mobs, they don't feel much more difficult. And, like, the extra XP boost and stuff is nice. But then you bump into a unique, and you're, like... It's like, you just sit there swinging. It's not, like, a hard fight. It just takes forever to kill them. It's like, oh, God. Start from elite. I mean, you could, yeah. Elite's more difficult, yeah, but I mean, it's what, like negative 25 resists? So it's not too crazy. Oh my god, we got three of these like mega chonks. It's gonna take a while. This is like classic WoW here. Feels good, man. Ultimate with no gear. Yeah. One nice thing about starting on like the higher difficulties, like elite and ultimate, is that like you turn in quests and you get like a shitload of XP, so it actually feels like worthwhile doing quests. Lore bonus. Thanks. A priest named Tuha arrived today. He is a hard and unapproachable man. He has to have his entourage put up for the duration of their stay, which I of course agreed to. After a night's rest, he has to be shown the premises, culminating in the underground chamber. As we made our way through the fort, I pointed out various features and soldiers of note. Priest Tuha showed little interest. Later on, he interrupted a demonstration by the blades and was asked to be shown across the bridge. I shudder every time I cross that expanse. Despite my training, I cannot help but fear falling over the edge. The water below would break my fall, but there's no way back should I survive its icy depths. Once beyond the bridge, Tuha became very interested. He examined every rock, every crevice, pushing and pulling on bits of the mosaic adorning the walls. He was searching for weaknesses, I presume. We spent the remainder of the day there. I sent for food several times, but he touched little of it. Finally, late into the night, he was satisfied of what I could not say, and I dare not ask. Okay... Veteran seems pretty good, but I don't think we need it that bad. Cadence. Ooh, fighting form, yes. Cadence now has some AoE to it. Wonderful. Am I equipping things? No. Alright, making sure. Paranoid. These casters.
Can't do that yet.
Why not put a point into the Oathkeeper summons? I have... Oh shit, I could. Fuck. That's a good point. I should throw a point into those things. But I mean, at that point, like, why not just be a fucking wuss and go back to town and equip my gear? What do you take me for, Selt? A coward? Just unequip my weapon, do this completely naked, no gear. How bad could it be? We're gonna do our monk playthrough today. I don't know what you're talking about, Selt. I've never done a cowardly thing in my life. But yeah, I probably should throw a point into those summons. It would be foolish not to. Dude, I think this dude's like actually just stuck in the terrain. Sucks for you, bro. A royal sarcophagus. What's the worst that could happen? Okay, that wasn't too bad. That helm's pretty bad, but... Okay. Ooh, treasure trove! I think that was our only dynamite. Need to make some when we get to town. Holy shit, that was a lot of iron bits in there. Very nice. A necromancer book. That little sand demon. Man! If I were higher level, I would have tried that, but I have a feeling it would have ended similarly to me trying to fight Mogdragon on my Necromancer, where it just ends up a case of, like, I can't kill it, and it can't kill me, so I'm just gonna go elsewhere.
I can't do that yet.
Have armor on? I do, you fucker. Quit equipping shit. If there's a boss in here, which I assume that there is, I'm just going to have a really bad time. Like, these trash mobs are one thing, but if there's a boss I gotta stand toe-to-toe with, oh boy. Feels like... The iron drops in here are really high. I think I just picked up like a pile of 600 there. On the following day, Priest Tuha had his entourage move in a large stone chest adorned with a griffin. It did not appear to have any hinges or lid. Whatever was inside it was heavy. It took a team of 20 mighty men working tirelessly all day to move it. By the end, their backs glistened with sweat and blood from their toils. Once the casket was in place, the priest instructed them to go rest on the bridge. As they made their way down, Tuha motioned with his scepter, and several of the blades of Atep descended upon them. They moved swiftly and mercilessly. Within moments, all of the workers were bleeding out on the bridge stone. Their throats slit before they even realized what had transpired. Tuha ordered their bodies to be weighted down with rocks and dumped into the waters churning below. The harshness and brutality were so sudden, I briefly watched in some silence, but then it occurred to me, the blades did not follow my orders, they followed his. The priest gathered what remained of his caravan, a mere handful of soldiers. I suspect they too were blades of Atef. I followed them back to the surface and inquired as to where the caravan was heading next. To that he said, "Some place deep that light has forsaken." He then gave me a look that made my blood run cold. A look that told me I should not ask such questions unless I wanted to join the rest of the caravan in the black waters below. Each night as I stand watch atop the fortress ramparts, I am reminded of the carnage that took place beneath, and the chilling realization that I am honor-bound to die in this place sets in. I find no comfort in the other denizens of the fort. To speak out about its secrets would sooner see me flayed by their vicious blades. In that, I serve alone. Okay. Thank you. I wonder if that talk could be a hint to a secret place. Yeah, I'm sure it is. Okay. How bad could it be? 50,000 hit points. Mother of God. And of course it summons ads! Son of a bitch.
I can't do that yet.
Stop summoning things. My poor hit points can't take it. Oh, and there's fucking wall bullshit. Oh my God. This is just gonna be a slog. Why? At least the thing's not like regenerating. It could be worse. I think we're gonna be able to do this. I just think it's gonna take a while and I may die, which is why I dropped that portal out there. Cause like if nothing else, I can just sit back and lob, I can just lob shields at it until it dies. It's just, you know, got 50k health. I'm doing like 200 points of damage and attack. Oh no.
That skill's not ready.
I would stand and fight with the thing if that fucking suit of armor hadn't animated off of the wall. But of course. If anything, I'm actually worried about running out of energy more so than health.
I can't do that yet.
Oh, another suit of armor. Wonderful. Now there are two of them. I guess at least our shield throw is like bouncing around and killing the adds. Like that counts for something. Walk north for the next armor. Oh, is there another one? No, he's not animating. He's just chilling out. Sadly. Although I see, is this one right here? There we go. Got another one in the corner? No. I mean, it's like, this isn't too terrible, like, it's not super, super intensive, it's just gonna be a bit of a slog, a lot of running in circles. The best part is when we throw a shield and it misses. Those are the ones that feel really good. Like that. One of them's almost dead, actually. Get out of here. Yeah, look at that, we killed one. Nice, I'll take it. He's at about 60% health. This raid only has maybe 45 minutes to go. We're gonna get there, guys. And then we'll run it on Mythic 80. Maybe once we're done with this, we'll get 1/8 of the shard that we need to fight the real boss of this league. Okay, the real important thing is the friends we made along the way.
I can't do that yet.
They have the mythic dungeon stuff. Oh, that... They're doing that kind of stuff leads me to believe that, like, folks are just gonna figure out, like, the best combos, and, like, if you're not playing that, they're just not gonna run with you. Which is kind of a shame. He's about half health. Nice. At this point, I'm almost... Woo! That was some damage. I don't know what that was, but I actually felt it. Do not want. Start a guild that told others to play what you like. Hey! That'd be nice. Like, that's, like, one of the reasons that I tend not to play, like, a lot of MMOs. Like, I would like to play Final Fantasy XIV, like, through to endgame. I'm about maybe midway through Heavensward. But the dungeons in that game get stressful as hell for me later on. I much prefer playing with more casual groups where it's like, if you wipe, it's just like, oh well, let's run it again, as opposed to people raging. Although, to its credit, Final Fantasy XIV is a lot better about that than WoW ever was. Level pox, but just waiting for your dots to kill everything.
Skills not ready.
Run in circles. Okay. Alright. Now it's just down to the fucking mages. I cannot stand and fight because that's just a really bad idea. But at least they're not, like, lobbing poison death everywhere. I mean, he's getting there. He's at, like, maybe, I don't know, 45%. Started healing boss. Celt, don't you even... If they heal this boss, I'm gonna go back and we're gonna get our gear. Like, this is not challenging, it's just wasting our time. Gotta do a whole playthrough like this. Just completely naked. I know people have done that with, like, Path of Exile. Which just blows my damn mind. ...15,000 health left. Yeah, no interest in Shattered Realms. I mean, I suppose, like, we might do one just to show it off. It's not anything particularly crazy. But I mean, like, I guess this shows you just how easy normal is. Like, we don't even need gear. Oh, if it nets me a shrine, yeah, okay, we're gonna do that. I do like shrines. And we are currently, like, under shrined anyways, because I just kind of blew through Act 1. Nope, get out of there. Caught up in enemies. 10,000. Missed at least two, yeah. I'd say once we're done with the DLC, I'll go back for them, but if I did that, I'd actually just do it off screen. Because it's not like that stuff will scale up with us. Hell, even like Act... I don't even know... I know Act 1 stops scaling at like level... 18 or 20 or something. It doesn't go very high on normal. So we probably won't even be, like, gaining XP for a little bit of Act 2, maybe, depending on what level we finish this at. And I know we'll finish the main game and be like in the 40s. And then on to Elite and Malamuth, which that'll be an adventure. Just go Elite? I would, I just gotta get the thing that lets me unlock it. We might. Actually, that would be a good idea. Once we finish this, yeah. I like that idea, so.
I can't do that yet.
Oh yeah, that's true. You do get the extra shrines. Almost got him. Oh, don't get greedy.
Not ready.
Is the bleed? Oh, the bleed got him. Get Shrek'd. Give me all your goodies. A slime bolter. I assume that's some dumpster tier gun. Yep, acid damage. I'm not even gonna bother killing those things. They're just buckets of obnoxious. Glamorous chest. Okay, I want to go back into that room to make sure we didn't miss anything, because we did not get the other seal. Make sure there's nothing in here. Doesn't look like it. Prepping lunch. Nice! Ah, shit, I went to get a drink. Curse you, game. Throwing encounters at me right off the bat. Oh my god. Get out of here, there's loot in here for me.
That skill's not ready.
Okay, well. Oh, is there more? There might be more. I was gonna say we'll go back and grab our gear, but there's more. No, I think this just loops us around. Well, wait a minute. I was supposed to get a piece of a thing, but we didn't get a piece of a thing. Okay, we're gonna go back and grab our gear, and then we'll poke around in there again. Why did I come back here? I didn't want to come back to Devil's Crossing. Alright, let's re-equip our pants.
Safe storage, no questions asked.
Ah, to have stats once again. Oh no, we did get the second piece. Alright, I didn't even notice we picked that up. In the darkness bound, Morgoth sought to disguise his intentions in light of a Teth, but by the grace of the Elder Sun, the veil was lifted from his machinations. He served a great hunger, and hunger is all he shall ever know. The way is shut, the heresy sealed, but should the Corbin faith be shaken once more by Morgoth's folly, then seek the final seal deep within the howling abyss. May no other ever set eyes upon the night's terrors. Alright. Okay. I mean, that wasn't, like, too terrible. It was just a slog.
I'll keep an eye on this.
I'll give you a good price of what I've got left. See you around.
Okay, and I think... yes, okay, so we're at another thing, so I'm gonna drop us back to the main menu and we'll flip it over to veteran difficulty here. There. Make things a little bit more challenging for us. Now that we've got some... offensive ability to us. Okay, I'll see how this goes. Should be a little bit more challenging. I don't know how meaningfully, but...
That skill's not ready.
I mean, they've certainly got more hit points. That much is true. It just seems to be these sphinxes that are chonky as hell. Everything else seems pretty reasonable. I do think we should probably maybe start cranking our damage up a little bit when we ding next. Stone Griffin, you're drunk. My damage is so bad. Oh, this is terrible. Okay. Anything hidden? Not looking like it. Their camp is right up here, which I will have to take. I mean, at least we can kind of stun lock them a little bit with our shield. Kind of locks down their damage on us a little bit. Stay over there. Oh my god, they're just everywhere. Damn griffins. Oh, and chunky. Oh my god, this armor. It went from 10,000 health to 18,000. Ugh. Painful.
That skill's not ready.
I actually have the totally normal bulwark, I think, sitting in my stash. Maybe. I have one of the shields from the base game sitting there. The other thing is that I don't have a bunch of gear with like plus skills on it. Whereas like when I came through like at this point with like my warder, I had, you know, probably a cadence of like 9 and I had blitz up to like 14. I should probably like reassign some skill points and maybe focus on just cranking up my offensive ability a little bit.
Can't do that yet.
But yeah, you do definitely miss out on some goodies that I would not mind having. Anorax journal. Oh, is this that dude's apprentice? Bet it is. Those. Oh, what do we got? Errol's got the three of us working with an odd crew, some bunch of witch-worshipping fanatics, but I have my trepidations. For one, getting mixed up with such a controversial group may prove more dangerous than it's worth. They also seem like a terribly conflicted lot, all pledging themselves to different deities, none of whom seem to get along very well. They've somehow roped my brothers into joining their little cult, though I suspect those two aren't buying into the mumbo-jumbo the witches are peddling. More likely, they think we'll turn a healthy profit by going along with the whole deal. If that's the case, Errol and Anne Duran are doing an awful good job hiding it. They're joining in with daily rituals, kowtowing to their new god. It's an odd sight, those two fools pretending to care for anything other than making themselves rich. I wonder how long it'll be until they try to get me to join in with them. I haven't had an opportunity to speak with them about it, but deceiving a group of fanatics like this could be a dangerous business. For the time being, the witches have kept us well supplied, and there seems to be no shortage of grave robbing they want us to do. I don't exactly know what they're looking for, but they don't seem to have any interest in the usual trinkets. They were rather displeased with our first haul, saying it was all useless junk. We just grabbed what usually sells well, jewelry, anything that looks expensive. But they said to focus our efforts on items that seem to have greater importance, auras, whatever that means. On top of all else, things are heating up in camp. The witches seem to be preparing for something, arguing amongst themselves, making plans in secret. There's a lot of strange people coming and going, and some rather concerning rumors about goings-on to the north in the ruins of Corvin City. We don't have any plans to head out there, though, at least I hope not. This morning it's off to the Cairn docks for a second run. There's a network of tombs and temples beneath the ruins that the witches seem particularly interested in. We've been down there before, and most of these places seem like they were picked over years ago, but maybe the stuff with auras is still down there. In any case, I'll have my hands full keeping Oral and Andoran out of trouble as usual. Built your warlord with righteous fervor instead of cadence. Yeah, you're not wrong. Like, going for multiple damage types. Normally I aim for two. But I'm just being a lazy ass. Full disclosure. Because, like, I could... pull some stuff out. But, like, I don't know gear-wise. Like, I don't think I really have any gear that, like, is going to give me fire damage. That's the problem. We got cold, of course, but...
Hey! I could use some help over here!
Oh, I think my leg is broken. Yeah, Anorak sent me. Anorak sent you? That figures. The guy worries like an old woman. He's always after us to be careful and watch out for each other, though I guess he was right this time. He's always right. It's incredibly annoying. Where's your brother? I don't know. I mean, he told me to run and he looked horrified, so I booked it. I never looked back to check on him. The whole temple started shaking. It was like an earthquake or something. I fell coming up the stairs and busted up my leg pretty bad. When I yelled out for Andoran to help, he wasn't there, so I hauled myself to the rest of the way up. He's still down there? Must be. Certainly didn't pass me on his way out. I'd go down there looking for him, but I can't walk, not with my leg like this. You going down there to find him? I suppose so, but let's get you out of here first. How are you going to do that? I'm certainly not walking out with magic! Alright. Yeah, I want to actually... let's zip back to town here really quick. Want to reassign some points. Let's see if we can't maybe do anything. I'm probably going to pull some stuff out of Soldier if I had to. Well, I don't know. We'll see. Let's see, where is... right over here.
I sense turmoil within you.
Pull out shield throw, and instead of shield throw, go for like force wave or something. Because I know that, like, I know force wave is not so powerful, I know blitz is not so powerful. But at the same time, yeah, Force Wave is great. Like, Force Wave will carry you through Ultimate. You can do, like, just a straight soldier with Force Wave and Blitz and just max them out, and you will be fine. Skills are amazingly powerful. It's just, yeah, it's very straightforward. Another point in a Virus Might, and then the next level we get, we'll just probably dump a bunch of points into our offensive skills. Although...
let me clear.
Do I want to give up?
Stay strong.
There, we'll see how that does. Cranking our damage up just a little bit.